Hello and welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Hindi, Punjabi and Gujarati with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Annie Sheikh and today's headlines are: In India, Railway Minister Suresh Prabhu has offered to quit on moral grounds after the recent train accidents. And striking down instant divorce is violative of the Sharia, a Muslim clergy group has said. In America, President Donald Trump has threatened to blow up NAFTA and Trump will shut down the government if necessary over the Mexican wall. In Gujarat, the reservation demands of Patidar community may resolve soon. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi may visit Gujarat in September. In Punjab, ahead of the Dera verdict, the states of Punjab and Haryana are on high alert. And the Aam Aadmi Party, along with the help of the NRIs, has come to the rescue of beleaguered farmer families. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, America, Gujarat and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: With two train accidents in 5 days, the government has replaced its board chairman A.K. Mittal with Air India Chief Ashwini Lohani. Railway Minister Suresh Prabhu offered to quit on moral grounds. However, Prime Minister Narendra Modi asked Prabhu to wait. The JUH, one of India's largest groups of Muslim clerics, has described the Supreme Court decision striking down instant divorce as violative of the Sharia. The group has also defined it as a matter of grave concern for the Muslim community. The Supreme Court has rejected the request of V.K. Shashikala over review of her conviction and 4-year jail term in a 19-year-old disproportionate assets case. The court observed that there was no merit in her plea and they did not find any error in the judgment. The Kerala High Court has exonerated CM Pinarayi Vijayan in the SNC-Lavalin case. The case pertains to an agreement with Canadian company SNC-Lavalin in 1997 to refurbish 3 hydropower projects which allegedly caused a loss of Rs. 266 crore to the state exchequer. The government has raised the creamy layer ceiling by Rs. 2 lakh. It also announced setting up of a commission to work out subcategorization within OBCs for a more equitable distribution of reservation benefits. The CBI on Wednesday questioned Karthi Chidambaram, son of former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram, for over 8 hours. This is in a case related to the alleged irregularities in FIPB clearance to INX Media in 2007. The Finance Ministry has announced the launch of the new Rs. 200 note. The move to introduce the new currency is to increase the circulation of smaller denomination notes. The Supreme Court has issued a show cause notice to BCCI office bearer Secretary Amitabh Chaudhary, Treasurer Anirudh Chaudhary and Acting President C.K. Khanna. It also issued contempt notice to Amitabh for not implementing the Justice Lodha reforms. The Committee of Administrators has been directed to formulate a draft constitution based on the order. Olympic 2012 bronze medalists Saina Nehwal, B. Sai Praneet and Kidambi Srikanth have advanced to the third round of the World Badminton Championships. Saina, seeded 12th, took only 33 minutes to dismantle the unseeded Swiss Sabrina Jacquet. Actress Jacqueline Fernandez says that she has embraced everything that Mumbai has to offer and now she has a keen interest to learn the beautiful Urdu language. The actress has Sri Lankan roots, grew up in Bahrain and says that she is loving her life in Bollywood. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from America, Gujarat and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are: President Donald Trump has threatened to blow up NAFTA after less than 1 week into the renegotiations of the trade agreement. Mexico's foreign minister shrugged it off as a leverage play and said that Mexico will remain at the table with calmness, firmness and in the national interest. President Donald Trump will shut down the government if necessary to make sure his proposed wall along the Mexican border is approved and funded by lawmakers. Trump wants Congress to finance his controversial plan to build a big and beautiful wall along the US border with Mexico. National Security Council spokesperson Michael Anton has highlighted that Pakistan is using India's role in Afghanistan as an excuse to pursue its policies in the war-torn country. President Donald Trump's new get-tough approach with Pakistan could potentially include sanctions on Islamabad. California lawmakers will hold public hearings in September to probe the rise of white supremacy. The hearings will be aimed at reviewing the safeguards and procedures in place in order to avoid violent conflict in future due to any white supremacist demonstrations or events. An Indian origin CEO was slammed and racially abused after he penned an op-ed for a news network following the Charlottesville racial violence. Ravin Gandhi said that he will not support a president who seems to hate Americans who do not look like him. The US Navy dismissed the commander of the fleet that has sustained 4 collisions in Asia and deaths of over a dozen sailors in 2017. The move followed Monday's incident in which the guided missile destroyer USS John S. McCain collided with a merchant ship near Singapore. Thousands of protesters descended on downtown Phoenix ahead of US President Donald Trump's campaign-style rally. Nearly 4,000 people indicated on Facebook that they would attend an anti-Trump rally at the Herberger Theater Center, which is less than a block from the convention center. Steve Bannon's Breitbart has taken an aggressive, critical approach to the president's address over his new policy on Afghanistan. President Trump unveiled his plan for Afghanistan after 7 months of deliberation, announcing tweaks around the edges of the current strategy instead of a different approach. U.S. First Lady Melania Trump has thanked former first daughter Chelsea Clinton for defending her son Barrett Trump against online bullying. Clinton came to the youngest Trump's defense after an article in the conservative news publication criticized his style and clothing. U.S. former Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton, in her new book, has called President Donald Trump a creep. Clinton said that he made her skin crawl by stalking her around the stage during a presidential debate. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Gujarat and Punjab follows. Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com, and the top 10 headlines from Gujarat are: the reservation demands of the Patidar community may resolve soon. Gujarat's Deputy Chief Minister Nitin Patel said that the discussion of the demands and the issues will take place in the meeting with the Patidar leaders. Prime Minister Narendra Modi may visit Gujarat in September. He will inaugurate the newly constructed gates of Narmada Dam on 17 September during his visit to the state on his birthday. A new explanation has been made regarding swine flu. Rajkot Commissioner Panchanidhi Pani said that the California H1N1 virus has been replaced with Michigan H1N1 virus, which has led to a spurt in cases. The government is hoping that the flu will reduce by September. The Congress has gotten offended for not getting any NCP vote in Rajya Sabha elections. Gujarat Congress President Bharat Singh Solanki said that they have decided to end the alliance between them as the NCP has betrayed their trust. BJP President Jitubhai Vaghani has told the Muslim community that the ban over immediate triple talaq is not in favour of any particular person. It is in the interest of the society and towards development. Swine flu is spreading widely in Vadodara. 900 employees of Vadodara municipality and 800 students of medical college are conducting a special survey and providing medical cures for the flu. Employees at Bhavnagar Shipbuilding Company are accusing the government of trying to shut down the company. The workers are on protest against the move as it will create huge unemployment. Hamirsar Lake in Bhuj is known for its beauty. However, people have surrounded the premises of the lake with piles of garbage. People of Bhuj have demanded to make the lake clean again. The Jain festival Paryushan is being celebrated in Ahmedabad's district Paldi Jain Darasar. Devotees performed rituals and celebrated the birth of Lord Mahavir Swami. Women of Bodhli village in Sabarkantha will create Ganesh idols with coconut sticks to make it 100% eco-friendly. Such idols are recommended in order to avoid pollution at the time of immersion. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: over 1 lakh followers have reached Panchkula as Haryana and Punjab maintain maximum alert ahead of the court judgment in a rape case against the Dera head. As a precaution, schools and colleges in Panchkula district have been ordered to remain closed on August 24th and 25th. The Aam Aadmi Party, along with the help of NRIs, has come to the rescue of beleaguered families of those farmers who committed suicides due to the debt caused by farm loans in Punjab. Leader of opposition Sukhpal Singh Khaira has disbursed a one-time financial aid of Rs. 50,000 each to 20 families. The Justice Mehtab Singh Gill Commission probing alleged police excesses committed during the 10-year SAD-BJP rule has recommended compensation in 130 cases of false implication. It has examined 172 cases out of total 4,200 complaints. CM Amrinder Singh is flouting the travel ban in the Congress manifesto prohibiting ministers and officials from going abroad at the state's expense during the first 2 years, the Aam Aadmi Party has alleged. Amrinder is slated to travel to Israel in September in less than 6 months of assuming office. The hearing in the income tax case of CM Amrinder Singh's son Raninder Singh has been adjourned till October 4. Raninder was summoned on the accusations of willfully evading taxes and penalties imposable under Section 276C of the Income Tax Act. Punjab has been told to put up a clear stand regarding measures taken to control stubble burning. The directions come after the Council for Punjab Farmers and Combined Manufacturers apprised the NGT that the state was not doing anything to control pollution and was only issuing orders. Haryana Sports and the Youth Affairs Minister Anil Vij has honoured 2 silver medalists of World Paralympics Athletic Championships. He also said that the first Paralympics complex of the country was being developed in Faridabad at a cost of Rs. 6 crore. Officials of different banks in Haryana under the banner of the All India Bank Officers Confederation staged a protest against privatization and merger of public sector banks. They also announced to go on 2-day strike in September and a 4-day strike either in November or December. A Ludhiana court has granted Bollywood actress Rakhi Sawant bail. This is in a case pertaining to some remarks she had allegedly made against Sage Valmiki. The court will hear the case next on September 11. The first edition of Miss Trans Queen India, a beauty pageant for transgenders, will take place in Gurugram on Sunday. At the final event, 16 contestants from Delhi, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Manipur, Karnataka and other states will compete to win the title. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.